G-Class really feels home. Why is that? On the one hand side, we are close to a big city, where the G-Class is frequently seen, and on the other hand, when you look outside here, we are on unpaved roads, where the G-Class really feels home. So today, in my speech, I want to talk briefly about three things. At first, take a look at the SUV family at Mercedes-Benz. Secondly, to discuss what distinguishes our G-Class, and thirdly, what have we done to make our legend fit for the future. So let's start with a look at our SUV/off-road family. It all started in 1979, and for the first 18 years for Mercedes, there was just the G-Class. And based on those genes, we have enlarged our portfolio. And this year, we at Mercedes are calling the year of the SUV. And that is for good reason, as on average, every quarter, we are presenting a new model. And the family right now consists of five SUVs. As you can see here, the GLA, our compact premium SUV, the GLC, our off-roader in a tailored suit, the GLE, our all-around talent with luxury and off-road capabilities of the highest order, the GLE Coupe, which offers driving dynamics in conjunction with the strengths of an SUV, and last but not least, our full-size premium SUV, the GL, that later this year will be announced again as the GLS with a facelift. And you know, our SUV family planning isn't finished yet. In Shanghai, we have shown the concept car GLC Coupe, which we are going to bring to the market next year. So you might ask, why are we doing this? I think the answer is obvious. The SUV segment is booming, and that is true for the whole industry. That is very true for us as a company. You can see here, we could increase our volumes by 25%. So far, year to date, that means the first 8 months of this year compared to the first 8 months last year. So the basis for this success story is our G-Class. And when we took a look at the G-Class, to us, the car is an absolutely exceptional model, and as exceptional is also the range of applications. Being used as a Papamobile, winning Paris-Dakar with Jackie X, or being used in other rallies, or just as a renowned and dependable companion for off-road journeys to the farthest corners of the world. And one reason for this is its nearly indestructible hardware. And when entering this tent, you have seen this blue car on the left. That car is called Otto. It belongs to Gunter Holthoff, and just last year he gained a world record with this car after traveling for 26 years the world with one vehicle. He made a distance of about 900,000 kilometers, that's 22 times around the world, with just one G-Class, one engine, of course, good maintenance. And he visited more than 215 countries. Taking a look at his car and considering he gave a name to it, Otto, we find it when we talk to customers many times that our customers feel so close to their G-Class, feel the character of the G-Class, that they give a name to their vehicle. And so, going back to Otto, no question the G-Class is for real adventures, but it's not only the G-Class of 26 years ago, where some people might say, with electronics of that time, you could still do it. Today, with modern cars, it's more difficult. It is just 3 months ago that South African-born explorer Mike Horn took two G-Classes out of our production in May, went to his recent home, Switzerland, and drove from there by car in 2 weeks to the base camp of K2 in Pakistan. And obviously, the 12,000 kilometers were partially on paved roads, especially to Switzerland, Germany, Poland, Russia. But from then on, it got more and more difficult. And as you can see here, roads and bridges were gone, and he had to be quite ingenious to find ways towards the base camp on the height of 5,500 meters. The G-Class is a living legend, and since the first day we are producing the G-Class in Graz with our partner Magna Steyr, and here's also something that distinguishes the G-Class from other vehicles. The G-Class is completely manufactured by hand. Here you can see a picture of some ladies that are doing the sewing work on our vehicle, but like this, also welding, etc., is done in the same fashion as it is done. It was done in 1979. The loyal fans of the G-Class appreciate both functionality and reliability of a true off-roader, as well as the hallmark Mercedes-Benz driving and luxury. And indeed, the number of fans of the G-Class is growing continuously. We posted an all-time high sales record last year, and in the first 8 months of this year, we could even grow further, as stated here, by 20% compared to the same period last year. And that is in the 36 years of production, and to us, this is as unique as the G-Class itself. Now, taking a look what we have done in terms of further development of the G-Class. Well, the G-Class to us is an icon and a legend. So we have been very careful in further developing our vehicle. What we have basically done is we have optimized the front bumper to allow for a higher cooling surface, and we have implemented a new instrument cluster. And that's it. And you, I hope you agree, it's a good thing that we didn't do more changes, as nobody would come to the idea of changing a Rembrandt painting either. However, if you would take a look beneath the skin, and that's obviously things we want to talk about, here we have done quite some significant changes, and I'm sure you could feel this already driving from Frankfurt here. We have reworked our suspension system. We have a completely new ESP system that is increasing handling stability as well as safety and ride comfort. We have optimized our ABS and ASR system, so braking distance is shorter. And for the G500, we are now offering an adaptive damping system, so you can choose between sports and comfort mode. And in sports mode, you have even more agility because of the reduced body roll of the vehicle during cornering. An even greater step we have done on the engine side. I'd like to start with our completely new V8 4-liter gasoline engine. It is based on the design of the engine that powers the GT and now also powers the C63 from AMG. Within the G-Class, it's offering 422 horsepower, 310 kilowatts, and 610 newton meters of torque. And that, I think, for an entry gasoline engine is quite okay. And while you had different cars to drive here, please make sure that you can also listen to it. Our engineers paid, like typical for the G-Class, a lot of attention also to the sound that you still get a V8 as you would be expecting a V8 to sound like. The engine can be clearly identified through its through the location of the turbochargers are in the hot V of the engine that allows a very compact design and helps with emissions. And that again helped us to reduce fuel consumption, and this engine takes in our car 17% less fuel than the previous V8. Talking about fuel consumption, we have made an even bigger step on our diesel. The diesel now comes with a fuel consumption of 9.9 liters. That's the most fuel efficient G-Class ever been built. But on the diesel, and we have here reworked our existing six-cylinder diesel, we have not only reduced fuel consumption, we have also at the same time increased power. The diesel engine now comes with 245 horsepower and 600 newton meters of torque. And for those of you that still remember the G400, our V8 diesel, that is only 5 horsepower less, but 40 newton meters more torque. So what we are doing here is, to us, downsizing at its best. We are offering V8 power to the engine, but fuel consumption of a six-cylinder engine. So looking at those vehicles, yes, we did some changes to the engine, but there are also some fundamentals underneath the skin of the vehicle which by intention we left unchanged. And that are the foundations of the off-road capabilities of our vehicle. That's first of all the three items. The ladder frame that's giving the vehicle its strength and durability. Secondly, our low-range gear that's giving you additional power when you need it in the applications. And thirdly, our three differential locks. And those ensure that if only one wheel has some grip, this ensures that you can overcome any hurdle that's in your way. And for those of you who have already driven our parkour here, you had the chance to find locations where only with three locks engaged you can master them. And for the others, enjoy it when you have the chance to drive. Yes, we have some customers who asked for even more. And for those, we have now the G500 4x4 square. It looks spectacular and it delivers accordingly. Some technical details are mentioned here. A ground clearance of close to 440 millimeters, 250 millimeters wider track, which is giving excellent stability going around curves. The body roll is really minimal. Because of that, we can also go up to speed of 210 kilometers an hour, even with portal exits. And the vehicle has a forging depth of 1 meter. You can see, and for the insiders of you, you know, the portal exits are derived from the G63 6x6 AMG. And speaking of AMG, we have also advanced our AMG engines. So the G63 is now stronger and comes at 571 horsepower, and the G65 is now matching our internal code of our vehicle with 463 kilowatts or 630 horsepower and sheer 1,000 newton meters of torque. So in conclusion, every engine of the G has now more power and most of them less fuel consumption. If you are looking for something more extravagant, we have now also added our crazy colors to the portfolio. And if you turn around, even in not so nice weather, rain and clouds, the cars are shining and give a smile at least to many of your faces, and ours, I can assure you. Even more exclusive is our AMG 463 edition. If you take a look, and some of you had the chance to drive in this, two-tone leather dashboard, designer leather seats, diamond stitching, carbon leather, carbon interior parts, and on the outside, 21-inch wheels. This really is a statement and a very, very nice car. So ladies and gentlemen, let me briefly sum up. We are convinced our legend has a bright future with its timeless design, with significantly more powerful and at the same time more fuel efficient engines, and better on as well as off-road capabilities due to the improved suspension system. So we are sure our fan base is going to grow even further, and we wish you an enjoyable noon together with us. As said before, our experts and myself, we are happy to ask any kind of questions you might have. Enjoy the good food that is prepared here, and don't miss the off-road track outside. Thank you very much.